Welcome to Building Manager Online. In this video, we'll take a quick tour of the basic features of our latest Building Manager Online energy management software platform. Navigate to the BMO website using your browser. While most current browsers will work, Google Chrome is the preferred choice. Other options may exhibit some formatting irregularities. From this screen, enter your user email and password to log in. This will take you to the main user management screen where you'll have easy access to the various properties and devices assigned to your user account. Clicking on a property will open the dashboard screen for that property. The property dashboard is customized with user-defined content. These can include summary totals of any of the metering points in the system, including virtual points. This can be an easy way to display the summary totals for code compliance. Virtual elements can be used to calculate the summary totals for each load type. Then these can be presented either as summary numbers, as illustrated in the top row, or as graphs, as shown below. Up to 4 points may be combined into a single card. Graphs may be formatted as line charts, area charts, or bar charts. And each element on the chart may be displayed as a different type. In the chart on the left, total demand is shown in an area chart with the temperature overlaid as a line chart. The chart on the right shows 3 separate demand values displayed as bar charts. Using the mouse to hover over the graphs will highlight the individual points and display the values for the specific points. Scrolling down below will show some additional information, including property details, current weather data, and a table listing all the devices associated with the property. The main apps menu is where you can create custom dashboards, build and view vital reports, and create virtual metering points. You can also use these tools to generate consumption reports and to set system alarms. Virtual points are an easy way to address code compliance requirements. One of the primary requirements of the energy codes is the disaggregation of load types. Lighting loads, HVAC loads, plug loads, and overall total load can all be calculated using virtual points. Then these virtual points can be displayed on the dashboard and used in reports. Using virtual points, the system will combine groups of meter points for similar load types to provide summary totals. Utilizing the virtual points to summarize the various load types, we can quickly build a vital report. From the table view of the report, the data can be exported directly either to CSV or Excel. This makes it really easy to get the data out of the system for things like code compliance reporting. Again, the dashboard can display these virtual points either as analytics, as shown at the top, or in graphs, as shown below. BMO follows a simple structured organization. Everything begins with a user account. Once you have a user account activated, you can begin setting up your properties and assigning the metering resources and hardware to your properties. BMO doesn't limit the number of properties allowed, so you can create as many as you need to support your requirements. The properties view displays a list of properties with their addresses and the number of devices connected to each of them. Now let's look at the devices view. The devices view lists all of the devices assigned to each property. The list includes devices for all the properties assigned to the user. This is an easy way to quickly see all of your devices and to check their current status. It's also where you will come to add new devices, update device settings, and disconnect or delete devices from the system. Another nice feature in BMO is the option to add weather metrics to the data. As you can see, there are a whole range of weather points available in the system, and these are all tied to a localized weather service based on the property's zip code. Going back to the main dashboard, you can see that it's easy to use this weather data for comparison with power consumption data. In this case, we're tracking total electric demand against the temperature, illustrating the effects of the temperature outside on the total electric demand. Each of the data acquisition hubs or gateways must be set to upload to BMO. This setting is done in the gateway. Once BMO is receiving data from the gateway, it can be assigned to a property. To add a gateway and assign it to a property, you must have the gateway's MAC address to identify and make a connection with it. Connecting is as simple as filling in the short form and saving it. Under each gateway are the devices or meters associated with it. This is where you will assign, name, and connect each meter. It's also an easy way to quickly do a system status check to confirm that all the meters are communicating properly. With the gateways and meters connected, you can then select the individual metering points to be monitored from each device. The points list will show all of the active points for each device. We've seen the dashboard and Vital Builder. Now let's take a look at a couple of other features that you may find useful. The consumption report is an easy way to get a summary of the consumption of all the devices connected to a property. Just select the property, fill in a date range, and put in a rate if you want the report to calculate the summary cost. Click the Generate button to execute the report. This is a simple summary report that can be generated for any property over any date range to quickly summarize the consumption data. You can also export the data directly to either a CSV file or Excel by clicking the links at the top of the report. It may also be useful to use the alarms feature to send email notifications when there are unusual readings coming from the system. Setting up the alarms is quick and easy. Just fill out this short form with the appropriate device and point, setting the upper and lower range limits for the point. Select the user that the email alerts will be sent to, and anytime there are readings outside the limits, the system will automatically email an alarm notification to that user's email. User journals may be used to keep notes related to the system, to user accounts, or anything else you might want to document here. Journal entries are simple text note fields where you can type in anything you might want to reference later. We recommend keeping records of the system setup and any subsequent changes. The document section is a good place to store these system-related documents, so they're easy to find if they're needed. You can attach a variety of document formats like Excel, Word, or PDF. You can use this document storage for all sorts of things, so it can be a great place to keep system and user-related documentation. Well, that was a quick tour of most of the key features of the new Building Manager Online System's base module. Hopefully, this was a helpful preview of the system. Please let us know if you have questions or would like to schedule a more in-depth demonstration. Thank you for your time and interest, and we hope to hear from you soon.